The latest information coming in from Parliament shows that the national budget will be released on June 14, 2023, and the figure currently stands at 52.7%, which has drawn a lot of attention and reactions from the public. On the business roundup for this week, we shall be discussing this and more. My name is Violet Sasia, you are welcome, and I am joined by Paul Busharizi, who is our analyst tonight. So thank you so much, Paul, for joining us, and let's start off with the budget, which currently stands at 52.7 trillion. This money in particular has got reactions from the public. Some of them have been via social media. We have 21.4 trillion that has been allocated for pensions and gratuity, among other things, which some Ugandans believe is redundant and does not exactly fit into the economic basket of Uganda. What are some of your thoughts about this, and how best can we see that the budget truly feeds the economy?
Well, first of all, 52 trillion is not a big figure.
Really?
Well, think of it like this. If you're 45 million Ugandans and you have 52 trillion, that means each Ugandan portion of the budget is like one million shillings. So that's 1 million for you to use over the next 12 months to do roads, to do health, to do education, to do water, to do defense. You can see it's not enough. So, you know, let's just say we're a poor country. We're a poor country, and we're cutting our cloth. We're cutting our coat to fit our cloth. So 52 trillion is not that big amount number. We probably need 10 times more than that for us to be living a good life, generally, as Ugandans. Secondly, you talk about a significant part of the budget going towards these things like pensions and what. Well, those ladies and gentlemen have done service for the Republic of Uganda. They are still alive. They deserve, they entitled to pay after. That's the way the law is written. And so it's not dead money. And they spend that money in the economy. So that money actually spurs consumption and therefore production. So it's not a waste. It's all our money. It still helps the economy.
So Paul, the World Bank released a report showing that Uganda has made no progress. We could say little progress in alleviating poverty in the last 10 years, and also the National Development Plan 3 released a mid-term review report saying that they had only performed at 17%, and some of the challenges they faced were poor planning, also allocation of money to weak projects that couldn't exactly return money into the economy. So what do you think can be done in this case to be able to have a huge return on, should I say, investment, and also to quicken the progress in terms of poverty alleviation?
I think one of the things that the National Development Plan does is shifting us away from what they call sectorial budgets to program budgets, program-based budgets. So in the past, you'd budget for education, health, you know, maybe water and sanitation. But now we are budgeting for human capacity development. So all these things are seen as almost one unit. So that's what program budget would mean instead of sectorial budget. Of course, you can imagine under the sectorial budget, there are silos. Everyone does his own thing and what. Under the program, groups of, let's say, ministries or sectors are being asked to come together and think together. So I can imagine if they say that NDP3 has only achieved 17% of what it should have achieved, it's because we're still breaking out of that mindset.
And once again, Kenya and Uganda are at a row when it comes to our milk exports. And this takes me back to last week's interview where we spoke about manufacturers in Uganda thinking that Uganda's milk could actually have potential if value could be added and we export more and also consume more. What do you think is the problem? Kenya seems not to want our milk, but we continually send the milk and it's bounced. We have had a challenge with agricultural products going to Kenya. So how quickly can we solve this, and what alternatives do we have in this case?
Well, I think, first of all, you need to remember that for the 70s and the 80s, Kenya was a supplier of Uganda's everything. There are whole industries that were built up to supply Uganda. Now, those industries are under threat as Uganda becomes more productive, especially a good example is milk. And Uganda is a low-cost producer. It actually produces milk or almost anything that Kenyans can produce agriculturally. We can produce it cheaper. So you can imagine there are a lot of these interest groups in Kenya that are pushing back. One, I think we should seriously consider alternative markets. So if the Kenyans hold us hostage, we have other markets. And two, I think it's they're just those are the kicks of a dying horse. The market will sort them out. I mean, they will resist, but it's too expensive even for the state to resist, because one of the things the state would have to do is subsidize those inefficient producers, which is a waste of money on their part. They should be using it in education, health, infrastructure, rather than supporting some entitled interest groups like guys who built their industries on the premise that Uganda will never produce for itself. But that's Kenya's business.
Yeah, indeed. Very unfortunate. So thank you so much, Paul, for having made time to be a part of this interview. We shall talk to you again next week. We wish you well. Thank you, dear viewers, for making time to be able to catch the Business Roundup here in the news. We thank you so much. I am Viola Xatia. Until next time, back to the news.